think the world, humanity's challenge will be over the next decade as we enter 2020?
Back to the principle, Lewis, of just different paradigms beginning to collapse, you know, economically, politically, socially, environmentally, religiously, yes. Education, journalism, medicine. They have to move into chaos. Mm. And chaos is just unpredictable.
Because they're not working.
Yeah, exactly. But now here's the challenge for humanity. You have one of two ways to embrace the breakdown of those paradigms. You can face them with anger and hostility and fear, and you are only contributing to more of it. We have to see that those breakdowns are essential for something greater to happen. Mm-hmm. Now, we can't wait for governments to take care of us. We can't wait for medicine to give us a drug that's going to heal us mm-hmm. from a condition. The truth is, with a greater level of consciousness, the change in awareness because of information, the greatest challenge we have as those paradigms break down is to no longer emotionally react in the same way and be victims. You can't say, this president, this person, this whatever, is actually making me feel this way and think this way. Basically, you're in the program that something outside of you is controlling you,
yeah.
how you feel and how you think. So then to self-regulate then is to say how I think and feel is going to change my outer environment. So then we're all faced with great opportunities brilliantly disguised as impossible situations. And we are at that point, at that nexus point in our evolution as a species. So then you don't try to fix that. That's never going to work. What you do is you create something better. Mm-hmm. And then everybody just naturally just leaves that and goes here. Now, it used to be some people would just come here and the majority would stay here because they're clinging to what they've been programmed or believe in. But now, because of information, everybody's like, that's not going to work. I already know it's not going to work, and I don't care what anybody says. This is working for me. So people are moving to new applications, to new paradigms, because it's working for them. So as long as we don't emotionally react to the breakdown that's happening currently in the world, and chaos is just unpredictable order, you know, as things move towards disorder, the novelty that's being created is literally chaos.
Mm-hmm.
Because the known and everything staying the same is order. But as you step out into that unknown, the chaos is unpredictable order being expressed through novelty. And we have to be able to learn how to take that disorder and with the application of brain and heart coherence, create more order. So you can't just say, hey, I'm standing up for peace and, you know, and being miserable with your coworker. You don't get to talk about peace until you're the living prayer of peace. Not just, we know crime rates go down and violence goes down when there's peace projects in communities where there's meditation on peace. But when those peace gathering projects end, you know, you see that crime and violence and everything returns back to the same level. So it's not enough to just think it.
Mm.
We got to demonstrate it. So if I'm demonstrating peace and you're demonstrating peace, somebody else, because of mirror neurons, is going to go, wow, that person's unpredictable. Wow, they're different. It's given me permission to do the same. So I think that ultimately moving into that state of being, you know, as human beings and creating unity, mm-hmm. that, you know, you keep watching so many programs on television that talk you into prejudice, that talk you into separation, that talk you into fear, that talk you into violence, that talk you into war, deceit, negativity. You're not going to trust anybody. In fact, you're going to see difference between you and me or anybody, because that's what separation does. But when your heart's centered and you feel connected, you don't see the person any longer, mm-hmm. right? You see something transcendent them. You see an essence, right?
Yeah.
And I think if you do that really well, that kind of emergence of a new consciousness that's less dependent on all of those outer things is really difficult to control. And if you want to control a community, control their emotions,
mm-hmm.
And control them in survival.
Right.
When you overcome your emotions you can see the hidden meaning behind all things. And when everybody's looking this way, you may be looking that way because you understand, look, you've just overcome your fear. Yeah. You've just overcome your hostility and anger. You've overcome the program of whatever it is. I swear to you, you are going to be able to connect people. And that then is the hope of the future. That's why I'm hopeful of the future, because I think that all of this that's happening in a world right now where more things are happening in a shorter amount of time. I mean, if you're alive in this world and you haven't been experiencing the quickening, you know, I said to someone the other day, the day where you end your day and feel complete because you finished all your work, you'll never have that. And, you know, there's always more emails and more things to check, right? So the demand has pressed us into this crazy realm of multitasking. And I think that you start shifting, where you place your attention is where you place your energy. So if you're shifting your attention all over the board, your energy is scattered.
Yeah.
So then when you start disconnecting from everybody, your boss, your coworker, you know, the news, your cell phone, your computer, and you start going this way, I think it's into the present moment. Then if where you place your attention is where you place your energy, and you're truly in the present moment, you got a lot of energy to execute. You got a lot of energy to use, and you want to be able to do that eyes open.
The more scattered your energy, the less you have to focus on pushing one thing forward.
That's why people's dreams don't happen, because
too scattered.
There's no look. If you keep putting your attention on some future experience that you are imagining with your mind, your body's going to follow your mind right there because that's where your energy is. But if you're putting your attention on everything known in your life, the shower, the coffee maker, you know, the toilet, and your body's following your mind every day to the known. But we want your body to follow your mind to the unknown, right? Yeah. Enough people get to doing that, and you could do better in creating things in your life. That we see this. Wealthy people in our work that have focused on wealth, some of them living in the back seat of their car, some of them bankrupt that now have multi-million dollar companies. What do you think they want to do with that money? They want to give it away.
Yeah, give back.
Let me tell you why. Not because of any other reason, is that they now know that they could create more.
Right.
Well, why, if you're abundant, why? Abundance to me has changed. Abundance means I have more than I need, like way more than I need. So if I have way more than I need and I know how to create it, then take it. I'll create more of it. So now you're no longer holding on in scarcity. You're making a difference. So wealthy people that have created a lot of wealth in this work, they want to give back. They want to make a difference. And I think that that's how we're innately wired. Mm-hmm. I think we're all innately wired to care for one another, to make a difference. And the living organism, our living organism, our community, we heal one another. That's what we do.
Right.
We inform one another. We encourage one another. We support one another. We shine for one another, not to outshine another person, to shine to show them that they can shine. And that to me is super healthy. Mm-hmm. So then I'm applauding your success because I want you to succeed, because you're telling me that if you can do it, I can do it. So, so there's no longer any separation. I think that's hopeful for the world. Then you start celebrating diversity. Then you're like, wow, you're way different than me. I wanna study you because I wanna bring that into who I'm becoming. Mm. Yeah, you create a strong community that way.
That's powerful.